They'll charge you fees and fees and fees and fees. Amen. You want to have a wealth manager? You better make sure that you either got him on a retainer or you got him, if he's doing it on per come basis, they can charge you whatever they want. You'll be spending 2 or 3% of your income on accountants and wealth managers and stuff, and you're only getting 1% interest back on your account, then you're losing money. So you got to be wise and know what you're doing. Pray for the president. Pray for the president. Romans 13:1 says, let every soul be subject to the higher powers. There is no power but God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Whosoever therefore resisteth the power, resisteth the ordinance of God, and they that resist shall receive themselves damnation. I shared this on Facebook, but I'm going to share it now to those that are watching. This past week, I've had two prophetic dreams, last Thursday and this Thursday. Last Thursday, I had a dream. And in this dream, I was sitting at a table with three or four people, and President Trump was sitting across from me. And I was standing in front, and I was preaching. I was standing in front, and I was saying, thank you for not allowing war to be for us to be in war, because you know the Democrats wanted him to bomb Syria and wanted him to fight Iran and wanted him to go into war. And he said, no, we're bringing all our troops home. We ain't fighting no more wars. So as I was telling him that, he said to me, would you pray for me? I said, yeah, I'll pray for you. And when I began to pray for me, I don't know, I guess I was talking in my sleep. My wife woke me up. So I didn't get finished praying for him. And so that was the first dream. That was last week. Then this Thursday, I had the same, again, another dream. This time, we were sitting at the table. And we were eating, and President Trump was sitting across from me. And I was speaking, and I was talking to him, and there was spaghetti on the plate, and there was something else on the plate. And I was talking to him, and he said, you know, we're in the 70s now. You can't just eat everything you want to eat. You got to eat healthy, and you got to do. And he said, can you pray for me? Will you pray for me? So I got up, and I went around, and I started praying for him. And I started just praying and interceding, praying in his, Lord, bless him, Lord, bless him. And then I started prophesying to him. And as I looked up, and he was standing there, and he was doing, like, give me more. I want more, 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 more. And so I woke up, and the Lord is saying that we need to pray for the president. He's asking for prayer. He was more excited about the prophetic, about what was saying. So I'm going to say a little prayer here, right in the middle of this message for the president. Amen. Is that okay? We can just intercede for a president. Amen. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the president of the United States. I thank you that you're instructing him on the way he should go, and that you're guiding him with your eye, and that your guidance and your leading is concerning your will and your purpose for America and for his life. Father, we thank you that he hears the voice of the good shepherd. We thank you that you know and he knows and he follows you in the path of righteousness. Father, we do not cease to give thanks and desire that he would be filled with the knowledge of your will and all wisdom and all spiritual understanding, with that he may walk worthy of your Lord and pleasing and being fruitful in every good work that he does, increasing in the knowledge of God. Father, we ask you to strengthen him with all might and strengthen him according to your glorious power. Give him patience, Lord, to all patience, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We pray, even intercede for his appetite. We pray, Lord, that he would eat healthy, that he would eat the right foods. We take authority over the enemy. We'll try to set up sickness and infirmity in his body. Father, we thank you, Lord, that you will make him known the riches of your glory, and that he, the mystery that is among the Gentiles, and that the Christ in him is the hope of glory. Father, I pray that you strengthen him in the power of your might. Father, I pray that the glory that he will give, have the spirit of understanding, the spirit of revelation, the spirit of knowledge of you, that the eyes of understanding will be enlightened, and that he may know the hope of the calling and the riches of your glory that you have. have for him and that the purpose that you have for him and for the nations of the world. Father, I pray for divine protection over his family, over his loved ones, over his children and grandchildren. We pray a divine hedge of fire around him and around the White House and around those. Father, we pray and we come against those spirits of Sanballat and Tobiah. We come against the spirit of Naaman, and we come against the spirits of these false counselors that have come rising up against him, that you would shut the mouths of lions even in his path that is trying to block him. We thank you, Lord, that you resurrect him from the dead flesh and you cause him to become spiritually endowed and spiritually understand the things of God. We pray that you open up his spiritual eyes, open up his spiritual ears, and that he may hear the voice of the good shepherd. Father, we prophesy and declare that he's a child of God, that he's a part of the true vine, that he's Christ's friend, that he has been justified and redeemed, and that he has been freed from sin's power in his life. We decree and prophesy that he is enslaved to God and that he has been being sanctified and set apart. We pray over the president of the United States, that he has been given the mind of Christ. We thank you that his temple is a temple of the Holy Spirit. We pray that the Holy Spirit will rise up in him with groanings and utterances that he cannot understand, that he'll begin to prophesy, he'll begin to speak in tongues. We thank you, Lord, that you will always lead him in the path of triumph in Christ Jesus. We thank you that you set him free in liberty, and as he is walking in liberty, the nation begins to walk in liberty. We decree and prophesy that he'll walk in righteousness, and the nation will rise unto righteousness. We pray, Lord, that he will begin to speak the truth, and the nation will rise and begin to speak the truth. We pray, Lord, that he will hear the truth and begin to relay the truth. Father, put a guard over his mouth. Put a guard over his tongue. Let him not say wicked things or the wrong things that the enemy will watch and try to catch him at his mouth. We pray in the name of Jesus, the plots and the schemes and the strategies of the enemy will be revealed. We pray that you will put counselors around him that will hear in the spirit and know the plans of the enemy that will try to attack him, try to attack the plans that he has for the nation. Father, we pray that you give him witty ideas to rebuild the nation, to renovate the nation, to open up employment, to open up things. We break the power of the enemy of Hitler and communism and spirits in high places that's trying to influence his thought, trying to influence his speech, trying to influence his dreams. We put a wedge of protection around him. We bind that Illuminati spirit that's coming out of Hollywood, that's coming out of the nation, that's coming out of California, that's coming out of New York City, that's coming out of Florida. We bind these spirits that's coming out of New Jersey. We bind the spirits on the East Coast and West Coast that are trying to attack this nation and destroy this nation. Hallelujah. We pray that his family be blessed with all spiritual blessings. We pray that you raise him up and let him be seated in heavenly places. We pray and prophesy that he is your workmanship. Hallelujah. He's created to do the work that you planned for him in the earth, and he will do what you called him to do in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 So, Mr. President, you got your prayers. Amen. I'm just being obedient. Now, the next level is the war in the heavenlies. We have the ground level, and then we have the civic level or the judicial or the financial level, which is in the Wall Street and the government and the parliament and the politicians and the House of Representatives. That's the second level. That's where the demons are trying to influence the laws and trying to change the seasons and the times and the laws and the things. But in the war in the heavenlies, that's where witchcraft and mind control and principalities and strong men and there's principalities over regions. But the Bible says the weapons of our warfare or apostolic career are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to pulling down strongholds. So in this realm, we have to submit to God in intercession and in prayer and an authority to begin to deal with the heavenlies. You just can't go fight the devil in the heavenlies when you haven't even dealt with your foot troops. You got to deal with your foot troops before you try to deal with a principality. Don't even try to go there. Just leave it alone. Let me deal with it. Amen. I'll deal with the principality. But if you ain't dealt with your foot troops, don't be trying to beat up the devil. Amen. Because he's got a doorway in your life. There is a warring that takes place in the spirit realm. Romans 8:26 says, now the spirit likewise help our infirmities. helpeth our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray as ought. The Spirit helps you with your infirmity. Infirmity is not necessarily a sickness. It's not necessarily a diabetes or cancer. You can have an infirmity of a weak mind, or you can have an infirmity of a mental problems. Infirmity is something that keeps you bound up and sick and depression and heaviness and discouragement and impatience and fear. Those are infirmities. I don't know these symptoms I keep getting. This feeling I keep getting. Well, pray in the Spirit with the Holy Ghost, and He'll help you with that situation. He said, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be understood or uttered. So when you start praying, and you're praying 5, 10, 15 minutes, just praying in the tongues, and then all of a sudden, your spirit begins to groan and begin to war. And that's the Holy Ghost overtaking you and having you war in the spirit, because you didn't know what you're praying. You were praying for your kids and for your cousin. Next thing you know, you in warfare. All right, you devil, I'm about to, and you're gonna went off somewhere. The Holy Spirit took over. And next thing you know, man, I prayed for an hour. I didn't know I prayed for an hour. I was struggling to say 5-minute prayer. But when you start praying in tongues and let the Holy Ghost take over, you'll be praying, you just be gone. Hallelujah. Shaking the walls, and neighbors be knocking on your door, talking about, be quiet. Be making all that noise. You be gone in the Holy Ghost. So it's a birthing and warfare in the spirit. It comes out of your spirit when you begin to intercede and pray about something. You just yield to the Holy Ghost, and next thing you know, you're praying for the president, or you're praying for your boss on your job. You didn't even want thinking about them, and all of a sudden you're into this realm that you're praying for certain things. Micah chapter 4, verse 9 and 10 says, now why does you cry aloud? Isn't there no king in thee? Is the counselor perished? For the pangs have taken thee as a woman in travail. Travail. Travail means to calf, to give birth. It's like when you're in prayer, it's like you're giving birth. Your back hurts. Your stomach hurts. You're bearing down, and you're pressing into the spirit, and you're like in travail. Paul said, I travail for you that until Christ be formed in you. We have to travail for our leaders and for the president until Christ be formed in him. He ain't all the way there yet. So we have to, Paul said, I got to travail till Christ gets formed in him. And Christ needs to be formed in him. He said, be in pain, labor to bring forth, O daughter Zion, for like a woman in travail, for now you shall go forth out of the city, and thou shalt dwell in the field, and thou shalt even come to Babylon, and thou shalt be delivered, and the Lord shall redeem thee in the land of thy enemies. So God is saying, I will redeem you. Is there not a king in thee? I'm the King, King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Allow me to overshadow you in prayer and travail and watch the enemy be destroyed. I'll deal with the principality. I'll deal with the power. I'm just using you to deal with him as you begin to give me your strength. Your strength is made perfect in your weakness. My strength is made perfect in your weakness. So we birth the next move of God. We birth revival in the church. We birth, we have to pray. In this case, ain't no Sesame Street prayers when you're dealing in the third realm. Because the devil ain't going to let you. Oh, please, wait a minute, Mr. Dell, I got to go home and get my Bible, and I need to get a scripture so I can give it to you. You better know your word before you go deal with that principality. You better know your word before you go deal with that idiot at your house. You're talking about, oh, Mr. Satan, I'll be right back. I got to go get a word. Let me go find me a scripture. What did that scripture say? It's too late now. Paul, I know. Jesus, I know. But who are you? Who are you? You better have some word in you. The devil will run you and your family out of the neighborhood. Amen? You'll be attacking everything. So the ground troops, that's what they do. They mess with you, and if they can't get you, they're going to get your family members. They're going to get your kids. They're going to get your cousins. They're going to fight them. They're going to keep you so busy on the ground level that you can't deal with the second and third levels. And then when you learn how to do Isaiah 58, praying and interceding, and God said, I'll break the yoke in your family when you pray for other things over here. I'll deal with your family. So you don't get in their skirmishes with your family, because that's God. I already prayed for you. Me and my household are going to be saved. You can go and manifest all you want to. You get saved when God's time, and he'll save you. I got to deal. I'm going over here because God's got something for me to do. Y'all keep running after your family members. Just go and pray for them, and let's come in agreement that they're going to be saved, and that alcoholic and that perversion and all that stuff is broken in their life, and that God's time, and he's going to break the yoke in their life. Amen. I used to tell my sisters that. My brother, this year older than me, he got saved first, and then I got saved. I mean, he saved the worst first. I think because I was the party. I was the dope man. I bring the party. I bring the jokes and all that. And then when they got saved, they weren't saved, and I tell my sister, I said, I'm so glad you saved. She said, I ain't saved. Yes, you are. You don't know it yet, but you saved. I've been praying. You saved. All of y'all saved. And if you hiding your liquor, I know. Why you hiding liquor from me? I ain't God. He the God. Amen. They would hide the liquor when I come to the party. Because they know I had change. It was a radical change. You know, this man, I was wild. Amen. I came in one day, hair, big old afro, and hair and goatee. And next thing you know, I'm all shaven and clean shaven. Face shining and glowing and stuff. Something happened to you. Amen. Authority. In the heavenlies, you have authority. First, Psalms 149, verse 4, 6 says, let the high praises of God be in their mouth and a two-edged sword in their hand to execute vengeance upon the heathen and punishments upon the people, to bind their kings with chains and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute upon them judgment written. This honor have all ye saints. This is an honor to bind these kings, principalities, and powers. He's given us the authority to execute judgment. The judgment is Jesus overcame hell. He took the keys of death and life and death. He went down in hell and preached to the captives and took captivity captive. He is over all of it now. And this is, he said, I'm writing it down. The judgment is written. The devil is defeated. His kingdoms are defeated. The kingdoms of the world shall become the kingdoms of our Lord and our Savior. You saints, go out and execute this judgment I just decreed. Amen. Go out and execute it. You the sheriff's police in the kingdom of God. And you go out and evict the devil everywhere you find him. You evict him out of his place. Amen. For this judgment is written. This is an honor for the saints to bind the devil and cast him out. You have authority to do it. We're not wrestling against flesh and blood. I missed this. The little picture I got up here is a picture of Joshua when he captured the five kings, and he told his elders, hey, come put your foot on their neck so you know you got authority. You know when we go to battle, God's going to fight for you. You're going to put your foot on the neck of your enemies. So know you're going to win your battles, even on the first level, on the ground level. You're going to win the battles in the commerce and that, and we're going to win the battle in the heavenlies. Glory to God. We wrestle against this picture that I have up here. Actually, this is over Yuan, China. In the sky, they saw a city, a principality over China. It's over there. It's on the news. It was on the news. Picture. They saw it. Say, what is that city over there? It was a principality. It's principalities over Roar. There's a principality over every city. We can't see it in the spirit realm, but they're there. And we have to take authority over them and push back darkness and push back these principalities that are over cities. To do it, we have to be wholly submitted to God. Jeremiah 50:14, he says, prophesy this. He said, put yourselves in array against Babylon, round about. All ye that bend the bow, all ye that speak the word of God, that shoot the arrows of God's word, shoot at her with the word of God. Spare no word, spare no arrows. You in the year of the pay of the mouth. Continue to say, Babylon, you're falling. Your walls are falling. The perversion in America is falling. The uncleanness in America is falling. The anarchists are falling. Prophesy the word of the Lord, for she has sinned against the Lord. We can't sit back and say, oh, look how bad they are. We're decreeing and declaring a turnaround in America. A turnaround in the nations, a turnaround will take place. Don't let fear torment. He said, put yourself in array. Joshua sent them out to battle. The Bible said they went out harnessed. Means they were in array. Revelation said the end time army will not break ranks, but they will climb through the windows and climb over walls and do mighty exploits for the Lord. Array means in order. It means to be at attention, being in formation, ready to fight. If you ever watch the old battles they used to have, The two groups would be on one side of the valley, the other side of the valley, and then they would take the catapults first, and they'd send big rocks with flames and oil on it, and they would hit the castle and knock some of the walls down. Then the troops in the front with the shields and stuff, they would step aside, and the guys with the arrows would shoot thousands and thousands of arrows, killing all the troops in the field. And then the enemy would send his men, cavalry, against them with swords and with spears and stuff. And these guys would get in formation, and they would have spears coming out the bottom, and they would stab the horses and knock them off the horses. And then these guys behind it would stab them. It was all formation. They were in order, and that's how they would fight. And they would send the horses in, and then they would send all the other troops in, and they start battling and fighting. And then while they're in the fight, then the other general say, bring the other troop up to blindside him and come around that. God, if you study God, he always had ambushes. Read the Old Testament. He said, set up an ambush, David. When you hear the sound of wind in the trees, go in there. Send some men around the back of the castle, and while y'all fighting in the front, and then when they come after you, y'all run. And then when they were chasing you, y'all go in the city and take the city. God had all kind of strategy. He had all kind of strategy. He always liked to ambush. You can ambush the devil because he's too stupid. He only comes one way. He don't even think about what he's doing. He said, I'm going to beat you because I know I'm strong and powerful. I'm like Goliath. I can kill anything. Go ahead. Come on. David, get a rock. Just get you a rock. Just get a rock. A rock? Yeah, get a rock. Get five of them. Okay. I'll tell you what to do. You throw the rock, I'm going to put an angel on top of the rock, and the angel going to guide the rock and hit him in the head. Hallelujah. You get out in the battle, he said, send the young men out. Well, they can't fight. Don't worry about it. The angel's going to be with them. There's going to be an angel with each young man, and when the young man meets his enemy, the angel's going to kill him. Oh, y'all don't understand the spirit realm yet, but we're going to get there. Praise the Lord. We will get there. Understand that we're fighting with the Lord of the host, the captain of the host. If he's the captain of the host, that means there's some angels with him. And if there's some angels with him, that means when we step out and start singing praise and worship and send Judah first, the angels start working on our behalf and begin to smite the enemy. Amen. You don't have to fight it. They just want you to open up your mouth and praise him. How are you going to show up to a battle? You got 50,000 soldiers with spears and swords and shields, and they tell you, don't take no hymn book. Don't take no sword. Start singing. I don't want to go. The army behind them got spears in their back. Y'all better get out there and sing. y'all better get out there and sing. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for this word, that there are three realms that we're dealing with. And some of them are natural. And most of it is spiritual. There are demons and spirits that are controlling people in the natural. They don't know you. They can't discern you. They can't even receive the word of God because it has to be spiritually discerned. And so, Father, I pray that the ears be open in this season over this nation, that people will be open and open up the eyes and let them see in the spirit the demons that are operating in people. And we thank you, Lord, for this word in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise God. Was that all right? I'm going to clip that prayer. Man, I'll take the prayer out and put it on a separate thing, but that's I'll put the YouTube up. We'll just put it up on YouTube and then we'll put the prayer out. So praise the Lord. Anybody need prayer? No, y'all don't need no prayer. Go ahead and eat some chicken or something. Huh? Oh, we got a communion. I'm sorry. Thank you for reminding me. Someone want to get communion? Make sure your hands are clean. Hallelujah. You only need one. Come on, Sheila. Come on, you can come. We ain't like we got 50 people in here. We got one tray who do. Hallelujah. Oh, she needs some hand sanitizer. Come on, we're doing it. It shall be well with your soul. Thank you.
Praise you, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And after the same manner, he took the cup when he had supped, saying, "This is the cup of the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat the bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he comes. And then, wherefore, whosoever shall eat this bread and drink of this cup unworthily shall be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. But let a man examine himself. Let a man say, Lord, I ain't where I'm supposed to be, but I'm going to get there. For he that eateth drinkingly, unworthily, eateth and drink of damnation to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this cause many are sick and weak among you. If we will judge ourselves, we will not be judged. So, Father, we thank you for the opportunity to repent and the opportunity to judge ourselves. And even though we fall short in some places, you're still sanctifying us continually. We're still growing in grace, precept upon precept and line upon line. So we commune with you and say, Lord Jesus, come even now, even in the earth realm, come. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, hug on, well, you can fist bump somebody and tell them, Jesus loves you, so do I. Amen. An elbow bump or fist bump or some kind of bump.